What's going on? Welcome back to a new edition of Zoe's podcast show. I'm your host, Zoe, and I'm going to let you know what's going down. Oh my goodness. We are in for a treat this weekend. I mean, it's just a whole bunch of stuff happening this month. A whole bunch of goodness is happening this month, man. I can't wait. This is like the best time to be alive, right? What a time to be alive. And to see everything that's going on this month. I mean, of course, we have the fight that we're going to talk about. Of course, we got that going on this weekend. And it's a great fight. I can't wait to see that fight this weekend, this Saturday. But if you're like me, not only that are you more pumped about, but you are pumped about G-O-T. That's right. Game of Thrones coming out this Sunday, man. Woo. It's been so long. It's been so long, and we're here. We're finally here for the final season, and we're definitely going to see what's going on. I mean, I pretty much stayed alive to see this final season. That's one of the reasons I stayed alive. I mean, I got a wife and kids and everything, but I stayed alive for this one, too. And then later on this month, we have Avengers Endgame. I don't even know. If you're a Marvel guy, if you're a person who likes comic book movies or anything like that, man, it is so amazing to see the Avengers Endgame movie finally come into place. We're definitely going to see what's going on. I just can't wait. It's so exciting. I put something on my Instagram this past week about which am I more excited about. Is it going to be UFC 236 with Max Holloway, Dustin Poirier, and Israel Adesanya, and Kelvin Gastelum? Is it that fight? Is it the Game of Thrones? Is it the Avengers Endgame? I still don't know. I had a few responses from people who comment on there, but I still don't know. I'm so pumped about this fight, and I'm so pumped about Game of Thrones, and I'm so pumped about Avengers Endgame. So I can't. They're like children. You can't pick one, right? But I just can't wait for it to happen. So we're not here for all that. We're here to talk about UFC 236, right? We're here to talk about what's going down to UFC 236. We're here to talk about my picks for UFC 236. All right, so now I just want to put it out there. The fight card is good. It's not amazing. You know, it's not a stacked fight card, you know? But the main card is crazy. Like, I've looked at the main card so many times, and I've tried to see maybe if I can, you know, pluck out a boring fight or a fight that might go to decision, and I don't see one. I don't see no decisions in the main card at all. I don't see them. You know, from first fight to the last fight, I don't see no kind of decisions. So I feel like it's going to be a quick night for a lot of people. And I feel like it's going to go down with so much finishes, either submissions, TKOs, knockouts, referee stoppage. I don't know. It could happen. Something could happen. But I really feel like there's going to be no decisions in this first, in this main card. There's going to be no decisions. So let's get down to it. Let's get down to the first fight. Ovin St. Preux, OSP, versus Nikita Krylov. I think that's how you say his name, right? Krylov? Yeah, I don't know how you say it. But anyway. So we got this fight going down. All right, so these guys are both coming off a loss. You know, Krylov is coming off a loss. And we know what happened with OSP. He came off a loss as well. Now, both of these guys are really good fighters. I like both of these guys. And with OSP, we know how what he does, man. We know what the Von Fluke choke can do to you, which is pretty much called the St. Preux choke because he's done it so many times. So we got that going on. And we also got Krylov, who's coming off a loss, but a submission loss in the second round. OSP is coming off a decision loss. So, with that said, I'm going to pick OSP. I'm picking him for the submission. I think he's going to get the Von fluke or the same proof choke again. He's done it before. This is a rematch that they have. He's got the same proof choke on Nikita like last time. So this is their second fight that they're gonna have, and I think he's gonna do it again. Even though, you know, he might try to get out of it. He's gonna look for it, but I don't know. Actually, I don't know if he's gonna be the Von Fluke choke, but I definitely think he's gonna win, and I'm gonna call it St. Preux W submission win, second round. That's what I'm gonna do right now. Okay. All right. So let's go to the next fight. The next fight, we have Alan Jourdain versus Dwight Grant, and Dwight Grant is coming off a win. So is Alan. He's coming off a win as well, but Alan is coming off a win from February of last year. So February of 2018, he won, and Dwight Grant is actually coming off a win that he had this following February. So February 2019, he actually won by knockout in the first round, and Allen won by knockout in the second round back in February. So I think, you know, Allen's going to be, you know, very, let's say, rested, very, you know, ready to fight. You know, he's tried to have a couple other fights, but, you know, none of them fell through. So with Dwight Grant, he's kind of been on an up and down streak. You know, we know him since the Contender Series, and he came out there. He had a second round knockout there, and then when he came into the UFC, his first fight was a loss, and then his last fight was a win, was it the knockout win. So with this one, I'm gonna pick Dwight Grant for the win, because I think he's in a groove right now. Like I said, he's just fought in February. I don't think anything is wrong with him. He said he's ready for this fight, and I'm just gonna pick Dwight Grant for this fight, and I'm gonna say second round knockout. I don't know, there's gonna be straight finishes, so take that. Next fight we got is Eric "Your Boy" Anders versus Khalil Roundtree. Now, this fight to me is flying under the radar. I think this fight is going to be a really good fight. Maybe fight of the night. We don't know. Because these guys can bang. These guys can throw down, and they can knock you out at any given time. So that said, man, I mean, Eric Anders is coming off a loss. He's coming off a two-week loss. Two-loss streak. And one of them was a TKO, which it was like a stoppage from the ref, and the other one was a decision. And then Khalil Roundtree, he ran into Johnny Walker with that first round knockout with an elbow and everything like that. So, you know, stuff happens. But with this fight, man, I go back and forth with this fight, because I go back and forth because these both guys can bang. And, you know, I'm going to pick Eric Anders. I'm picking your boy to win this fight. Now, I could be wrong, because I love Khalil Roundtree, but I just don't think he has the wrestling abilities to go to, like, the second round or the third round or anything like that. So I think it's going to be a second round TKO. Eric, your boy Anders, is going to come back with the W and get the win. And I hate that I picked against Khalil Roundtree, but last time I picked Khalil Roundtree, Johnny Walker happened. But, you know, what can you do? So that's what's going on with that. Now, the co-main event of UFC 236 is upon us already. Kelvin Gastelum versus Israel Adesanya for the interim middleweight championship. I can't wait for this fight, man. I can't wait for this fight. It's just been too long to me since we've seen Kelvin Gastelum. He's fought. It's been too long. And of course, he's supposed to fight when Israel fought Anderson Silva and won that fight. But he was supposed to fight there, and then, you know, the whole thing with him holding the belt and Israel talking about put down the belt and all this kind of stuff. So we haven't seen Kelvin Gastelum in a while, but we know that he packs powerful punches. He got that background in wrestling, and he can, you know, take anybody down, and he can, you know, ground and pound with the best of them. And he has that knockout power, man. You know, he can just catch you. And if you box with him, you trade with him, and he catches you, it's lights out. It's lights out. But Israel Adesanya is a different dude, man. Israel Adesanya is definitely the last style bender. Israel Adesanya is that dude who can just, you know, keep his distance and come through with strikes and you know, just frustrate him to make a mistake and probably catch him as well. But with this fight, I'm going to pick Israel Adesanya. He's going to be the new interim middleweight champion. I've said it before on my podcast, my early podcast, I've said it before that he will be a champion this year, and this is the time. He's going to be a champion. I think he's going to knock out or TKO Kelvin Gastelum in the, I'm going to call third round knockout, a TKO, and he will be the new interim middleweight champion. I think Israel Adesanya is just that dude, man. He has to strike in. I don't think he's going to get taken down. And if he does get taken down, I think he knows how to get up. So, but, you know, I don't know, because Kelvin Gastelum is the wrestling dude. He can know how to get people back down. But I don't think he's going to be successful in the takedowns with this one. I think he's going to try to, but it's not going to work out for him. So I'm picking Israel, the last style bender, Adesanya. I'm picking that dude. And new interim middleweight champion of the world. Now, it comes down to the main event. Whoo, I can't wait for this main event, y'all. I am so stacked. This is one of the fights that is going to be a classic, right? This fight right here is going down a classic already. I haven't seen the fight yet, of course. Nobody's seen the fight yet. But this is already going down a classic. Max Blessed Holloway versus Dustin the Diamond Poirier. Now, let's talk about it, man. Let's break it down a little bit. Now, okay, Max Holloway is moving up from featherweight to lightweight. Dustin Poirier has made that transition a few years back. And, of course, this is the second fight. This is their rematch. And, you know, Dustin Poirier, he had beaten Max Holloway back then, but that was Max Holloway's first fight in the UFC, and it was last minute, right? It was a short notice. And these guys throughout the years have been so great. It's been crazy. It's been awesome for these guys, man. Of course, Max Holloway is the featherweight champion, and Dustin Poirier, he's just, you know, like the number one or number two guy in the division of the lightweight. He has not ever had a title shot. This is his first title shot in the UFC. So, you know, he's never had this platform. He's had this platform, but pretty like fight nights. So, but he's never been a main event in a pay-per-view. Max Holloway's been a main event. Max Holloway has been there, done that so many times, and he's, you know, beaten the best of them. And Dustin Poirier also has beaten the best of them in the lightweight division. And, you know, of course, he's beaten Eddie Alvarez. He's, you know, knocked him out. He's beaten Justin Gaethje. You know, he did that to him and, you know, gave him his first, was it second loss or first loss? I don't remember. I think it was his first loss. I don't remember. But, Dustin Poirier is the truth. He's really that dude. He has the heavy hands. He has a ways to getting his strikes in. He can trade with you. He can box with you. He can do anything. And he has a really good striking abilities. And of course, like we've seen before, he has that submission ability as well. He can take us to the ground and he can do anything that he wants to do there. Now, with that said, Max Holloway is the same kind of dude, but he also has the submissions, the strikes, the boxing, the know-how, and everything like that. But I'm going to pick Max Holloway for the W. No, it's hard for me to pick who, but I'm going to pick Max Holloway, third round TKO. I'm going to pick third round. Third round TKO. I think Max Holloway is a different, he's on the next level right now. He's on the next level. And he's still young. He's still in his 20s. I mean, Dustin Poirier is in his late 20s, but Max Holloway is still in his 20s. Like mid to late 20s, and he's on another level. I mean, his striking is crazy. The way he just, you know, took out Brian Ortega, the way he took out both times when he took out, it's messing me up on the top of my head. It's messing me up. But it was just so crazy. And I think Max Holloway, he can trade with you as well. And with his moving up in weight, I definitely think he's going to pack a little more power in his punches. And I think with the distance that he's going to have as well, he's going to know how to do that. He can trade with you, but I don't think he's going to trade with you. I think he's going to get hit a couple times. And that's the thing, too. Dustin Poirier, he gets hit. Max Holloway gets hit as well, but for these past couple fights, he hasn't been getting hit that much. I mean, he gets hit, like, whatever, blah, blah, blah. He takes, like, you know, some jabs here and there. But he hasn't got rocked or haven't got stumbled or anything by anybody in the past few fights. Dustin Poirier, he's been in, like, a few wars, you know? Not to say that his chin is weak. His chin is strong. But he's been in a few wars. I think he's, like, is going down a little bit. But he's definitely knows where to strike. He definitely has that striking ability and that accuracy to get you when you trade with him. That's when you trade with him. But I don't think Max Holloway is going to trade with him that much. I think he's going to have maybe a one or two session of trade. But I don't think it's going to be that much. I think he's going to have his distance, do his championship ways of fighting. I think he's, like I said, I think he's on that next level of being a champion and knowing how to win and knowing how to, you know, beat opponents and how to, you know, integrate his plans and, you know, just win. So I just think Max Holloway is going to win. He's going to be the new lightweight interim champion. And nothing against Dustin Poirier at all. Dustin Poirier is that dude, but I think he's going to get hit a little bit too much, and I think he's going to go down in the third round. Max Holloway and new. That's what my pick is. That's all I got for today, man. Thank you guys for listening. If you're watching on YouTube, thank you guys. Make sure to subscribe on the channel and make sure to like. And if you got any comments, make sure to put it down as well. And anybody who's listening to me on, you know, audio, either it's Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Google Play, Anchor, Spotify, all those, thank you guys for listening to the podcast. Please come back. And I thank you guys for everything that you guys do. Make sure to enjoy the fights. And if you love Game of Thrones like I do, make sure to enjoy that. I'm definitely going to enjoy that as well. And if you're into comic book movies and the Avengers and Marvel, what can I say? Endgame is coming, man. I can't wait. But thank you guys. I'll holler at y'all next time. Until then, enjoy the fights. Enjoy the whole month of greatness. Peace.